What's up, you guys? It's Emmy Bree, and welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new, hello, welcome. Thank you so much for stopping by to my channel today. You guys can read from the title, Miss Kylie Jenner came out with a swimwear line, and it has been so controversial, you guys, so I knew I had to test it out. I got as much as I could from the collection. I spent my own money, $400, on this haul. I was able to get 4 bathing suits. We are gonna be doing a full, honest review of Kylie Swim, so let's go ahead and dive right in. I feel like I should mention right off the bat the packaging, and it took about a week and a half to get here. I know some people are getting it a little bit quicker, but this is the box it came in, just a regular yellow box, and when you open it up, it has a pink lining. And let me tell you guys how disappointed I was. I have no hate to Kylie. I absolutely love her. I think she's absolutely beautiful, but I was super disappointed in this packaging. It came in this tiny little plastic thing that really reminded me of like Shein or Zaful. For $400 worth of swimwear, I was really expecting just a little bit more, maybe some nicer packaging or more eco-friendly stuff. I was super disappointed. Let's go ahead, try on the swimwear, and let's talk about it. All right, you guys, this is the one-piece swimsuit, the Calcose, and I picked this one up in a size large. This is a bathing suit that Kylie, I think, first teased on her Instagram, and this was also the one that I was the most excited to get. Let's talk about it, you guys. I have a few thoughts. I feel like, just in general, touching the swimwear, it feels very buttery, very soft, but so thin. There is zero lining at all. It's not even double lined. So let's talk about the top portion here. Again, I ordered a size large. Overall, the design is super cute. I do have a natural bust. I feel relatively supported. This is definitely not one that I would like do any type of like water activity in, but you have a tie around the neck that weaves through here, and then you have the crisscross strap which attaches to the bottoms. I will say I do like the back little metal pieces at the end of where it ties, but y'all, we need to talk about this sizing. I know Kylie said size up when in doubt, and I did get one that is an XL. This is so tiny. I feel like kitty coverage is zero to none. I feel like this area right here is just so tight on me, and I feel like it looks okay, but in some angles I just feel like it is just so tight right here. I will say there's a decent amount of room up here for the bust, especially if you have a bigger bust, but overall for $80 I feel like I am disappointed in the quality of it, just because I feel like I cannot wear this swimming or anything like that because it is so thin, and literally I feel like if it got wet it would just show everything. And this is the back. This is about as much as I can show you guys of the back region, or else YouTube is gonna be very unhappy with me. Definitely a thong back, which is fine, but I also feel like there's only certain places that you can comfortably wear this, or if you don't even feel comfortable showing that much. Overall, I feel like I will keep this one because I do like the design of it, but definitely disappointed in the quality for the price. All right, you guys, I'm gonna go ahead and try on the next bikini. Next up, we have a one piece called Kylie, and I'm pretty sure Kylie said that this is her favorite swimsuit from her line, and this is the bikini that I picked up in a XL. I got this in an XL because I just knew that if I had to give this bathing suit any type of chance, I needed more room in the cup, so I went with the XL. Having it on my body, and some of the models that she had beautiful curvy models. How the f did they fit this? Honestly, this does not feel like an XL in any type of way. Like, I'm surprised that this fits the way it does. So again, I have natural chichis. The support, I give it a 2 out of 10 because it does have adjustable straps, but this cup is so tiny. I know that I do have like a pretty large bust, but still, I'm like, where is the typical person's boobies supposed to go? Because if you look from the side, this cup is just not about it. It does have some pretty seams, but again, the singular lined fabric that is thin. Like, I can't get over that.
As for the back, it does have a nice clasp, and then you guys can see those adjustable straps. In the front here, there are a series of 4 pieces of boning, have like stitch lines next to them. I do like the way that this one looks. Again, practicality with that single line fabric. Like, what happens when this swimsuit gets wet? Like, that's what I wanna know. Again, this is an XL, like I just, beyond me. There is a little bit more coverage in the front though, which is nice. And this is the back, so you guys can see, definitely very cheeky again. Also up closer so you guys can see, it does have this little chain up thing, so maybe that's where it like could fit more size of people, but don't you think the back should have adjustments then too? I don't know. I feel like the little lace up is a cute idea, but I feel like it's very outdone. And that makes sense. Like, I feel like I've seen that so many times. On a positive note, I do like all of the colors in the collection. I feel like they're very cohesive and really pretty and complement so many skin tones and different hair colors. So again, this is the Kylie, and I picked this up in an XL, and this swimsuit was $85. All right, y'all, while I am semi-clothed, I want to show you this infamous yellow one piece. Kylie teased this one so much on the Kylie Swim Instagram, and I was obsessed with it. Knew it probably wasn't going to fit my chest, but I wanted to give it a go. I feel like this one specifically has caused so much controversy for how sheer it is and how unwearable it is. So again, we have this little bag. This is so lackluster. I'm just like, I feel like this haul's so negative, but I'm sorry. So this is the bikini. It is yellow, and I will insert a photo of what it looks like on, because your girl cannot even put this on her body. There, let's see if my studio lights. Look at that. You can completely see the label through it. And I don't, when that's on, look at that. Look at that, Kylie! The label is super cute and would be adorable if you couldn't see it through the back as well. As for this one definitely has the most narrow kitty space. I feel like this bikini is very much so giving me Borat vibes. Literally, where is anything supposed to go? Please tell me, because I am confused that this is a size large. Kylie, she's got some chi-chis too. Like, I don't understand at all. And the back is just as tiny, which is fine. I'm down for a thong bikini. I'm down for a cheeky bikini. But just the front, like what? I just don't even understand. So this one is definitely getting returned for $80. I do not want the world to see my nipples. I'm tempted to keep this just to try to get it wet and see how much you can see through it, because if it's sheer dry just like this, I can't even imagine what it would be like when it got wet. All right, you guys, so this is the last bathing suit I was able to pick up from Kylie Swim. This is just named the Red Triangle Bikini, top and bottom. These both were $40, making out for an $80 swimsuit, which isn't horrible. I feel like that one is pretty competitively priced. I picked this one up in a size large. Overall, I feel like this one is not bad at all. I actually do like this one. This is just a regular basic triangle bikini, and I hope my camera's picking it up. It's definitely reading like very hot pink, but in person, I'll insert a picture here that maybe shows it off more. It is pink, but it does have red tones in it. The coverage cup wise for a size large, I feel like is relatively comparable.
Oh, sorry, I tried that like an idiot, but you guys can see it has the metal, and then it has the metal here as well, just the little eyelets on the end.
Again, she is single lined, you guys. Like, I just don't know why. I don't know who let that fly in the long chain of her team. But the bottoms are very cute as well. I do like that they have adjustable sides. So you can kind of adjust it to your hips or how you like to wear it. If you like a little bit more low rise or high rise, I tighten mine to try to keep it up high up on my hips.
We're noticing a theme. This one is also very cheeky. This is definitely a thong. I do feel like this one would be very good for tanning.
So this triangle set came in the red, and it also came in the yellow, which I didn't get, and I am so glad that I didn't. Judging by the yellow one piece, it would have been so sheer, and I'm guessing it's singular lined as well. So I will say overall, the designs are so cute. I just feel like the execution is just not there yet. I feel like there are so many other amazing swimwear companies that just fit better, and the quality is overall better. I just want to reiterate, no hate to Kylie in the slightest. I was just expecting more as a consumer. I definitely think I will be keeping this one, and then the Kelcos one. Those were definitely my two favorites. So there you guys have it. That is my full review of the Kylie swimwear line. Overall, my thoughts are kind of across the board. I really hope Kylie takes the critiques that have been given, not by myself, but by a ton of other people, for her second swimwear launch, because I was really hoping for just some better quality, especially for the price. I feel like she was able to charge more because it is Kylie Jenner. If you guys like these more so like honest review videos, let me know. I would love to do more. I hope you guys like this video. Thank you always for watching, and make sure you guys are following me on Instagram and all of my various social medias. Thank you from the bottom of my heart, and I'll see you guys next time.